For larger organizations with tens, hundreds, or even thousands of users, the ability to draw is only part of the issue. Really, the ability to be able to capture that information, to upload it seamlessly to the backend so it can be processed, so users can share the data, and how they can secure their proprietary information, such as their libraries and their forms, become as important or even more important than the ability to create. Populate the forms and create the drawings in the first place. So in this video, I'm going to try and demonstrate how I've addressed some of those issues without going to a totally bespoke application. And so by providing the security up front, we can actually address the issues of how well it draws very quickly in the process, and we don't have to wait until we do all this other stuff, and then at the very end have the ability to worry about the drawing itself. So in this case, I'm going to show an example of where I'm connecting in. This would be if I download the app from a server, from either their server or from the App Store. And because I'm securing the application, the first thing they have to do is they have to address the licensing issues. And I've created a very simple account and password for this. So it's just going to be their username. And I'll just put in my name, etc. And then they activate the lease. And this is now hitting, if I can hit the button. This is now hitting my server to activate their lease and to authorize the device. If they scroll down at this point, they can now actually, and actually I'm going to close this up first because I want to demonstrate something. So if they open a new document, they're not going to see any proprietary documents. Similarly, they're not going to see any of their proprietary symbol libraries, etc., any calculations. At this point, they just have a blank authorized device. But because they've logged in with their company name, I can provide them with a standard company configuration. And in this case, it's just going to redirect them to their backend services of the company itself. And so when they load this, it's just going to change it so that now it's looking elsewhere. And we can demonstrate that by going to the open, and we'll see that now we have the ability to, and I haven't saved any files for this particular example yet, but we're now hitting the backend server. And that before was not enabled at all. They couldn't see that. In a similar fashion, it would be redirecting them. And again, I don't have any data stored there, but this would be taking their user ID and getting their appointments. But they still don't have their configuration. But because it's been redirected now, if we look at the setups, it's now looking at the company's setups. So you could have a bunch of these for different roles, or depending upon the region, if you wanted. Within the Raleigh-Durham area, for example, you wanted them to connect to one server, whereas in San Francisco, you want them to look elsewhere or have similar libraries and forms for the particular region. They would be set up. They could select that. And now, if we close this out and we look over at the libraries, we now see that we've got proprietary libraries that have been passed down to the device. And the security for passing this down is now controlled by the company itself. So I'm passing up user ID, password, along with a unique identifier for this iPad. So they can take that and then decide whether or not it's a valid request on their end. Similar fashion, they would then have their forms. And if they wanted to, at this point, they would do that same authentication to bring down their appointments. So there's a lot of security that's built into it. All they need to leverage it from their backend side. And for example, because the way I've created my form logic, if all they do within their application, and we'll look at this proposal, and we'll go to a second page here and look at the text, as long as the data that's coming down maps directly to the fields that are in the application have been defined, then all that information will be pre-populated. It's expecting a large JSON blob, which consists of a dictionary, which has the field name and the value that needs to be populated, and it will actually pre-populate their forms. So that demonstrates how we can easily take, and then configuring these is actually very simple too. It's literally draw the field on the screen and then put the field name in there. And so they can take a PDF and just lay this out very quickly. In a similar fashion, they can actually manage their libraries also in a very user-friendly sort of way. So this demonstrates how GraphPad is really ready to at least go into the preliminary trials of seeing if the drawing works, getting user feedback, almost immediately after starting a project. And that's my presentation. Thank you.